So before I get into genetically modified organisms, I want to talk about what isn't a genetically modified organism. Students really get confused with this word, and more so than today. So as I teach this to you guys, I'm very biased to be for or pro genetically modified organisms. I know what is out there as far as articles and different organizations really using GMOs as a scare tactic to refrain from using this technology. And that's totally okay if you have that opinion. What I want from you guys is to know the difference and to be knowledgeable on what is a GMO, what isn't a GMO. Because a lot of the times I see this stuff and they're kind of quoting and referring to things that are not GMOs, genetically modified organisms. So that tells me that they didn't do their research. I want you guys to do your research and then you choose. I don't want you to leave this lecture being for GMOs, being for CRISPR. I just want you to know what the science is behind it. So let's go back. What isn't a GMO are these guys. So selectively breeding would be an example that isn't a GMO. You're choosing the genes to get passed on, like Mendel selectively bred his pea plants. Here, humans have selectively bred food to increase production. They're not genetically modifying their genes. That technology didn't exist yet, but they are selecting the genes to get passed down to the offspring. So here, check it. We have wild corn. This is going to be a representation of wild corn. 7000 BC. Look how drastically the corn has changed. We gave this little tiny bit of output from that corn. Look at the corn today, modern corn. And humans in 7000 BC didn't go in there and change those genes in order to give us this production. Just thousands of years over time, we've gotten these massive corn products being produced by selecting the corn that will make that offspring. Watermelon is another example. We can kind of see the difference here with not having so much edible portions, lots of seeds in that 17th century painting. Our watermelon looks very different today. This isn't a GMO. It is selectively breeding these food items. Dogs are another example of selective breeding. Horses, beautiful example where humans have done this over time. So these are not genetically modified organisms known as GMOs. Mutation breeding is another example that is not a genetically modified organism. Mutation breeding is basically, we don't do this as much today as we did in the 1930s, probably between 1930s up until the 1980s, we kind of stopped using this technique. It does exist. There's actually an area here in California that still does it. Mutation breeding, also known as induced mutation breeding, is when we expose organisms to mutagens, such as chemicals or UV radiation. So that's going to cause mutation in that organism quite quickly, as opposed to it just happening over time. So we're really promoting mutations to happen. And then we basically, okay, I want that trait. I got a mutant and I like that mutant. Let me go ahead and get that mutant and take it and make offspring. So that's called mutation breeding. Some examples that you guys might have been exposed to using mutation breeding are the ruby red grapefruit. The ruby red grapefruit was in an atomic garden, is what we call those gardens that we use mutation breeding for. They are controlled in the United States. Regulated. And basically, it's a mutant that was created. Scientists decided that the mutant, after exposing it to UV light, mutated it. They decided that they liked the more darker, more vibrant fruit, barely any seeds. They decided, okay, that ruby red grapefruit is a lot more profitable than this guy. People are going to buy this guy more than this guy.